Oh, fuck, oh, this movie's all fucking.
That is so nice, though.
No shit. How much is that worth? Like 30 mil?
More thick now. Look at the interior of that thing.
What? Look at Steve.
Yeah,
Steve.
Looks like you're struggling a little bit.
I'm so fucking sick,
man. It is. I couldn't figure it out as well. Chodisms? That interior, though, is actually insane. Of course. Especially like a Cesta. Just like a Cesta. If you got like one of the other cars, it might be a bit easier because.
Are we all just there?
Yeah, we just walk around and just fucking see what we can find. That's why the worst part of this though, you gotta like try and push out the content as fast as you can.
I know. But it takes so long to edit.
It does, yeah. Oh, he couldn't even afford a headlight. I think more. So that's running less than like 1,000 or less.
Yeah, I'm fucking. Broski.
What's the issue with events like this?
Don't take a picture of a child's ass. That's not good.
I hope it's not a child. It doesn't look like one.
Oh no, my smoke. I didn't see his bin.
Oh my god.
Yes, please.
No!
So he really likes our super, doesn't it?
We started leaving and then just instantly came back. I'm trying to get one here whilst I'm waiting. It's an issue with an event like this. Tom's struggling a lot with his fucking filming, because look, he starts filming and then someone walks in front of him, the poor guy. Because that's what he focuses on. I do like both. Oh, I'm gonna have fun with the Supra. I might have to come back later. Where is he? Is he still trying to get shots of them?
Oh, the hurricane with the parachute. Pretty much.
You're there. There you are. Wow. Did you get actually any shots? Or?
Yeah, I got a few too.
Okay, that's good.
Everyone's hogging the back of it.
Yeah.
To wait for.
Over there,
yeah, people are waiting fucking half an hour to watch it.
So the thing is for me is that I started taking photos of a fucking Supra. Got it perfectly aligned. Everything. Guy walks in front and has to take photos of the engine bay. Has to be over the mirror. I was like, great.
They don't notice, man.
Then I just gave up.
What's your tripod? What the fuck?
Oh yeah, there's quite a few people with tripods here.
What's the point?
I don't know. I was about to say no exposure, but it's not really that dark here. Fuck it, people ruin my photos, so.
Oh, for an eye.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, look at that mini with a big turbo in the front.
Fucking hell. Where the fuck did Tom go? The two Tom friends of mine are both in red. Maybe. The two friends of mine that are called Tom, both are wearing red. I love when people try and fit a fucking. I love when people put a roof box on a fucking Miata.
So stupid.
But it's funny as well.
Real though.
Yeah, to be honest. Oh shit!
Yeah,
we can go around. I see a 190E, that's really nice as well.
I want to see the Prius Prowler there. I've only ever seen one of them.
Oh, we'll go around, man.
It's like, super rare.
Oh my god, Lambo doors. Oh, literally says Lambo door.
Oh, I got that too.
Oh, this is that Hurricane.
Yeah, twin turbo.
Both of them are twin turbo.
What?
Both of them are twin turbo, right. And the purple one. Is that? I've never seen pop-up headlights like that in a Miata.
Yeah, they have one
in the
M1 as well.
Really? Not a rude way, but that car's really out of place.
Oh, that?
Yeah, I don't know what it is.
What is it?
Is it British? Is it? Oh, is it Bristol?
British.
Maybe.
It was a Healey.
It's a bit out of place next to one of these cars.
It's really old.
You can't lie, it's a bit out of place.
There's a Golf R32 there.
R36. Oh, is it Golf?
It's not 32, it's not Passat.
Oh, I thought it was Passat. I can't tell from the front.
I saw a Passat R36 Estate, JDM import on Marketplace. You might be interested in.
Maybe if the fuel economy was actually all right on them.
Oh, the fuel economy is terrible.
Exactly.
Four-wheel drive, I mean, yeah.
I saw that. I saw that. It was going to be mental. Single time. I don't know how much it's going for. Literally, every single time I line up a shot and I'm about to take a photo, someone walks in and then just stands in front of it.
I wouldn't be fucking wrong, to be honest.
I need content for my Instagram. So it's a factory option, you can spec. Yeah. It comes from factory like that. This is nice.
198.
Should we just loop around, yeah. Yeah, let's loop around then, let's go through the middle again. I'm trying to spot Tom, but I can't fucking see him. Yeah. And this is went to the other side. Honestly. See, that's the thing with me, if I go to the event like this and I want to take videos, I'm going to do it when I've been invited so I can go around privately, like when it's quiet. I'll do like photos and shit.
Well, I get what you're doing, man. You've got a brand to do with it.
Yeah.
I was looking at that. There's no point in me doing it.
That bike's cool as fuck.
No?
That bike's cool as fuck.
My Alfa Romeo. Oh my god.
And a Ferrari truck thing. Thank you.
Oi. I was lining up the shop, man.
We were wondering where you went.
Yeah, that's just our mental. No space there.
Yeah. Well, we'll hear it from here, that's the thing.
You can watch it.
Nah.
I can't be honest.
We'll hear it from where we are now, so it's fine. If we just stay in this area.
That's absurd.
Yeah, what we're going to do is go around this area, go back around there, and then go to the other side. I've never seen one Enzo in person, then there's fucking an Enzo and an F4. Yes. The thing for me is with photos is I can always just AI out people.
Yeah, yeah.
Unless they're in front of a car.
Videos.
Then I can't. Yeah, videos you can't. But the issue is when you're trying to do AI, if you're trying to do it in front of someone in front of the car, it fucks up, it doesn't know how the car looks.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it fucks up the car.
Oh, do I enter?
Fuck it, man. £10. What else are you gonna use that £10 for? Other than food today. Oh, it's only 40 or 50.
What's that modified shit?
Yeah, stage 2 Stage 2 shit. That's a super legere, I just noticed. You know it spits flames when it's got fucking fire marks on the diffuser. It's melting the diffuser away.
What's the 1 PM in the drawers?
That was it? Oh, it's still got 30 minutes. Oh no, it's 7 minutes they start up the car. They start up the Cessna Lamenta.
Well, it's alright, you can take it out.
Still like 1 in 800 chance. Still not bad. Fire? A man caught on fire? So I've got good odds.
I'm sure his car caught on fire.
Yeah? Exactly, it's a sign. Fuck off with a Mercedes that loud, the speakers. Oh no, it's speaking behind it. I was about to say, there's no way Mercedes can play that loud with a speaker system. Entering.
Maybe.
that's good. We've got to peer pressure him. Tom, go on, enter the giveaway for the
man,
2 Series.
You know that car?
Yeah.
The play with the Enzo?
Yeah.
It's actually Enzo, and it costs more than the fucking F50. The play.
Not bad.
That's stupid.
And it's just parked up there casually.
That's the fucking player. Enzo, what the fuck? What a sick player. That's his car.
Get a photo as well then. photography.
What a sick car.
That goes hard, to be honest.
Huh?
That goes hard.
Oh, that is hard.
The thing is, this is why I want to come to these events like as invited as if privately with someone.
Yeah, yeah. It's hard to
come like early in the morning and like it's still dead.
The thing is, though, if you smash media and you see it,
yeah, true.
You've met a lot of guys.
What?
That woman's coming. Yeah. This is it.
Well, oh, I know which one you're talking about. See that PT Cruiser? Is that Slam 7? No,
it's
wait.
It's not a PT Cruiser,
eh? Oh no, it's a fucking, what's it called?
That's
a Prowler.
I saw one went off the jet.
What's that? 7 Series? No.
No, it's 6 Series.
Is it 6 Series? Does it have the badge on the back? Let's see.
Oh, it's a 5. It's an E34.
Is it E34?
Sorry, 7, I'll be right.
Yeah, on bikes. Oh, there's that E30. Or one of them.
I reckon that our fingers would be
it. I think it is, from what I remember. thing with cyan is like the easiest car colour to take photos of.
Yeah.
Cyan is like the easiest car colour to take photos of, or like paint type. That is fucking wide. That's why I tried to, that's why I got it. Get that old school look.
That would work too well. Only the camcorder has to be done. Seth, the camcorder has to be done.
Jeez. You got tape in there as well.
No,
so you modified it.
Yeah, yeah, so it records it on an SD card, so
that's
I don't need
so
tape.
Cool.
Yeah.
Love it. You got much footage?
Yeah, I'm trying to get as much as I can around here. It's got a 64 gig SD card, but it only does like a gig for like an hour, so it's like a stupid amount of footage I can get. Well, I'll get some shots after that, I'll run these.
Take care.
Hey, you too. That's how you get attention, she's bringing camcorder.
Yeah.
Basically bags them.
That experience is, you know, it's special.
I say it's like a 4D experience. You get to feel it, you can smell it, you can see it.
but the actual feeling inside your body, the vibration, is something you can't. Because when you combine it all together, it's something you can't really explain.
Oh, do you know what I mean? Shot,
yeah. Yeah. Like shortly, yesterday, talking about EVs versus
electricity.
We'll talk about that on there, we'll talk about that, but there's something special about the noise they want to,
I might have to just say more photos and just stitch them together to get one like photo that's like clean.
That, to me, that's art, and it's just absolutely stunning. And as a kid, you know, you have a picture of a 911 or a Ferrari up in your bedroom wall, whatever it is, or a Lamborghini. That's someone's dream, and there'd be a young kid here looking around and being inspired by a shiny car he might see, and one day they might own that, and that's great. And I think that's what this show's about. Not only does it showcase so many different varieties
of cars, as good as a photo would be.
We can always come back down, mate.
It actually gives people a vision to know what they have, what they might like in the future. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I mean, I was
able to get a 205 GTI, and I got one, and it was the hot hatch to have. What colour? Red, it was red, and I loved it.
It's like 2.5 meters or something.
But now,
I see
cars higher than a 205 GTI.
Holy shit. How long do you think that is?
It's an old car, and things have moved on a lot, but yet, that still has a market. That has people who love the old retro cars, and, you know, there's people who have modified their cars to within an inch of their lives, and it's amazing to see. You know,
I've never seen one of them. Neither have I. Well, I've got so many pictures of it already.
Of course,
you have. Done an amazing job here. This is something that you've never seen anywhere before. It's so top level. It's like in the field.
Has it got a rotary or what?
Yeah.
It's
been 12, eh? Thanks to cars. So, yeah, obviously,
it's been about 10 years. It's also re-engine. Like that. And just that recognition of buckles, belt, trousers, zips. These cars are so special. It's about being safe. I love that aspect.
Yeah,
yeah, you've got to be careful, obviously.
Have you seen what it says on the sunstrip? I like that, to be honest. If I got my car, I'd get that fucking sunstrip on it. Just to piss off everyone.
Ferraris or
whatever. Yeah, fuck it. Man. If I'm buying a McLaren, I don't fucking need the money.
There's so many.
After 300,000 miles, Lago. You can't see it digital, unfortunately.
Ah, for fuck's sake, Lambo. They should have just left the fucking, like, got a charge and left the battery on, just so they, like, everyone can see it's 300,000 miles. Oh my god, I just got a really nice photo.
If you've been through, like, 9 purchases, like, 100 pairs of tyres.
I'm not surprised.
Yeah, it is, it's an experience car.
Oh, like on the track days? Man couldn't even afford a headlight. Imagine how poor he is.
With his V-spec GTR, 150 grand.
That thing is probably making power. What? Uh-oh. Oh, but it's one of those, like, it's on a ball.
Oh, is it?
That does not look safe, like, when driving. I feel like that thing is just gonna go, like, whoop, whenever you're driving. Hanging my balls, which is my camcorder. Interesting build, but I like it kind of different. Not that bad.
I like the color on this.
I think it is like the BMW individual, from what I remember.
I've seen a couple of them like that.
Yeah, it's factory, but it's like.
Oh, it's not.
Yeah, there he is.
What are you doing?
Had to piss off every fucking Ford owner.
I do love that.
Yeah, it's cool though.
Why does it fit so easily? Well, you'd have a normal Ford car, yeah. It's got quite a lot of room.
Yeah, he does, to be honest. Like, he can easily service this thing. Oh, fuck.
Quite a small radiator, right? Quite a small radiator.
I'm assuming he has done some fabricating and shit to get it fit properly. And like cutting and shit.
100%.
Cool.
I would go over that fight.
Yeah. Tom, that's the Alpina I was talking about.
Yeah, I'm already got pictures
rare,
of it.
Yeah, it's super rare.
I like this guy's modeling.
You need a proper camera lens, don't you?
I'm sorry. Well, if you're going to get a mod of your car, you might as well go all the way. What? Oh yeah, I see it. Oh, that booth dish. It's CS, yeah. Proof on OCS. On bags, I think. I hope. I hope it's on bags. Just for the fucking... Is it?
So.
Bit of a big engine. Bit of a big engine. Where is it? Yeah, it has to be. You can't. Because it. I think it's a 5 series, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't think it's an M.
No,
like an
it'd be 520M.
Yeah, probably. Yeah, it's a 6-spot, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or do you want to go to the pink area? How big is the upstairs?
Same as all of this. Oh, I want
to. Yeah, okay, let's go. Well, the pink area shouldn't take too long. Yeah, some cars are.
But the thing is, they need a car of white too.
Yeah. You couldn't use it as a family car or something. Yeah. Especially with your kids in the fucking backseats of the chocolate balls or something. GTI. I'm all forced to be honest. It's gonna look quite pretty.
On GTI, you can get the V5, VR6, LFA2.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's a car park. Wait.
Yeah, that's not a car park.
What the fuck? What?
That's great, maybe that's the event parking.
Like, yeah, there's more event parking maybe.
Let's have a look in there. Oh, there's some nice cars. Oh, I love this. That. RTB trim bits.
Oh, yeah.
I love my one,
yeah. Did you hear that, kid?
My first
Need for Speed, the Eclipse. That's what I mean when I say the Eclipse is like, it's rare, but it's also not.
Well, it's rare in this country.
It's rare in this country.
It's not a rare car. If you go to America, you say, oh, I've got the Eclipse, and some cheap crap.
Yeah, that's the funniest part.
In like,
That's the funniest part.
Anywhere else outside America, it's like, it's
actually quite, holy shit,
quite rare.
An eclipse?
I don't think they're that expensive if they do pop up, but they're rare.
Nah. The issue is that there's just not many, because there's not many people wanting one.
Well, I don't know.
Not as many.
I think the demand would be high if more people knew. It's not really a car you like lust after. It's not like a really
yes.
car, is it?
No.
No money club. Oh, that's where I need to be.
No money club, but they're selling tags and shit.
Are they free?
Yeah. Yeah, you should go up to them and just say. Tom, I'm gonna see that 190. This.
That was a bit tight,
isn't it? Shit, yeah, what the fuck? That's not a four cylinder.
26.
What? Is it, what?
Is there an M606?
This is not 190E. Is it? No, it doesn't say. It's German though. It's got German plates. Is it 190? They never came with a six-cylinder.
I don't believe so, no.
So, I can't tell if it's been engine swapped or it's some like very special edition.
We need to check out the cab park.
Yeah, we'll do in a second. I'm gonna walk around like here a little bit. Like, I wanna go down this area and then go into the car park. Yeah. Because I want to obviously.
We got to look downstairs as well, right?
Yeah. Well, downstairs is not going to be too long. Probably give me 2 seconds.
But you just mentioned there that you wrote a book. Like, to any
of you, oh, that's where
I would start really quickly.
Thanks, man. Wouldn't be in the police car? Yeah, there it is. That thing sounds fucking sick.
What is it?
LSX. It is such a fucking crazy car. Full carbon fiber. Oh shit. questionable. Like I said, the DBLA, if you check this number plate, they still think it's a 235i.
Well, it sounds got a number plate.
I don't know about the front one, I can't see any front ones, but it's got a rear one, yeah. Been here if you want, Tom. Yeah. Lambo. Apparently, it's fucking hell. I respect it though. Wait, he camps in it?
Yeah.
That is mad. Wait, where is he sleeping tonight? That is. He's even got like a winch integrated in the bumper, look.
Yeah.
You know, I respect that.
Cut out with a grinder.
Yeah. I respect it though.
Like, very expensive.
You don't see it. Brabus 6x6. Yeah, V8, but it's upgraded by Brabus. I think it's got like nearly. I think it is 700 horsepower, that's why they call it G700. Oh. That's why they call it G700, because it's got like nearly 700 horsepower. The thing is, these are rare in the UK because most of them are like in Dubai and shit. So
there's not really a need to have a car like this.
No. Oh, that one's not a 6x6. A 6x6, that's just the G-Wagon squared. Sorry, I'm quickly. When you said you saw a 911 Dakar, do you mean a baby one?
Yeah.
That's quite cool.
I didn't really realize it was a baby one because I saw
the front. It's quite cool, actually. You think I fit?
Oh, for children, you're
like, oh, yeah. I'll fit in that one though, probably. Just a little modification. Yeah, there it is. That's cool. He's got a quite cool channel.
Yeah, I know.
Like, making like. Oh, really? He's blown up now. He's gotten quite big now. That's cool. I like that. Oh, really? I respect. Wait.
He just saw all the videography shit. You like it.
Really? When he sent it to me. I respect Dad Carl though, because he like makes videos of like.
Yeah, quite. It's like a different take on the genre.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Because everyone's doing car reviews, he's actually like talking about like using it as like an actual family car and shit.
He's like a really nice guy as well, I think it's about half an hour.
Really? Double trouble. Ah, it's nice. See the front grill to see. I didn't even know he had one. Since when did he have one? Mel Gumball. That's cool. That is fucking. We came at the perfect time. Everyone's just fucking left. Well, yeah. Or someone's cut it. Could be one of the two, honestly. You never know nowadays. Toyota V6.
What?
V6 from Toyota.
Toyota V6, Jaguar V6.
Is it? Oh, it is, yes. I can't believe you forgot about
that. I bet that manifold costs a lot.
Yeah. That's a cool Jag. It's a Jag. Don't tell that to Tom Linford over there. Over there, he takes care of these kind of jags. He specializes in jags. He's a jag specialist, yeah. So he's got quite a few jags. Might have swapped converted it.
What?
He might have converted it because he does a lot of conversions.
Don't really know what gear box you put on your back.
Something. Could be from another jag. Now you got, what's his name now? The Aventador. Is it? No, that this one. Isn't this right. Not, what's his name now?
Mark's in it.
But he just does like a lot of crazy shit.
Mark McCann,
that's it.
That's his Ken Block thing.
But yeah, he... Which I can imagine is worth quite a lot now. Imagine Mark McCann's Ken's Block's Focus of yesterday is worth quite a lot now.
Oh, that's quite twice it took to aim a high price. That's all it is. That colour on the hand end is incredible.
Yeah, it does. That P1.
And a 1M at the back as well.
Oh shit. That'd be nice.
And a Vantage GC12.
Do you know, I'd actually like to own a 1M.
They're more than they were when they came out.
Huh?
They cost more than they were when they came out.
I know. They've gone up so much in value.
Because they're so rare.
And they're actually quite good cars.
Everyone's a
technic car.
Hey guys, it's me here.
There's meet and greet.
Ah, but... The thing is, I don't like meet and greets.
What?
I don't like meet and greets.
I like it when it's forced.
Yeah, exactly. Like, if I stumble into them and start having a conversation with them, it's different. This would be.
I haven't either very cool cars.
Yeah. The thing is like. What?
Bubbly.
Oh no. Do you know what's quite funny though? So you know like that bumper and the diffuser and shit?
Yeah.
You can get those, that replica style for the normal E82s to make it look like a 1M. And.
There's flared arches and all the.
Yeah, I've done that. I was this close to buying an E82 and making an M1M rep. I was so close to making a 1M rep. I'm not a fan. My issue is I just don't like Ferrari, the brand.
I don't like the brand.
I don't like the whole mentality of... Yeah. I don't like Ferrari's whole mentality of like, oh, you can't buy one of our cars. Oh, you can only buy one of our cars if you already own one of our cars.
That's the
period. Yeah. Weird paint job. Oh, GTR. That GTR's cool though. Side exits. There's someone who's making a full-on M3 GTR rep. Like,
with the engine?
Putting a V8 engine in it from
the
BMW.
Well, the S65 or an actual M3 GTR.
No, you can't get one, that's the issue. He's just making a 318i into it. So he's just putting an S... with the V8 engine in it. I want to remember. I still want one.
Oh.
I really want one. What's going on behind it? Is it facelift or pre-facelift? Oh, I'm trying to check some. Pre-facelift. Oh, interesting. Oh, that's cool. It's quadrifoglio as well. What? Holy shit. The wing is winging.
You see, it's got like a weird
brush. Yeah.
Do you know the deal with that?
Might be adjustable.
No. Basically, they made a DTM version of this car with 2.5 V6 in it, twin turbo. And they basically said they can't use it because just the spoiler is too high compared to the
car. Off.
They just
buried
those brackets and the bolts loose in the
boot.
Fair
enough.
That's what
they are. Smart. That's cool. Smart engineering. Do you know what, Tom? Do you know what I wonder? How many cars have gonna like struggle to start up here? And then just won't start.
Alfa Romeo.
Probably, yeah. Actually, well, the thing is, there's already got someone's. I just built something. I was about to say. Is it just like a drink or something?
Yeah,
I've
got a Supra.
Is that a Supra? Oh my god, I just saw that
RX7. Yeah.
Holy shit, that's cool. The only thing I have an issue with the Veilside RX7s now is everyone. No, but it's not even that. Everyone has the exact same colour scheme and paint job on it. I know, but like, it'd be cool to see something different on one. That is wide.
Very wide.
What's that? It's like what? 10, 20, yeah, 10 to 15? That's cool. It's like what, 10 to 20 centimeters wider in the rear?
Well,
It's like 10 to 20 centimeters wide on the rear, on each side. Is it? Do it, like, it's like that wide. Well, you want to buy one? RX-7 Vale side.
No, not
really. Oh, it's Yuki's car. Yuki's SDK.
I think all the cars here.
I don't know how many.
The Eclipse as well.
I don't know if any of them are actually the ones from the film.
They got one of the...
Could be. I remember this Evo. Oh, come on, move out of the way. I can't fucking get rid of it. I can't get rid of the reflections in it, it's so fucking glossy. Yep.
I can't be legit. Oh, it's not legit.
No, it's not. No, you can see. It can't be legit.
Top.
Yeah. Just.
That's quite bad, actually.
I feel like the movie cars from they did the same. From what I remember.
Yeah, because the throttle body's over there.
Yeah, they just made up with electronics.
Yeah, that's not obviously so good.
Oh, yeah.
But I hate this so much.
Shouldn't have said anything. In your garage or on your driveway or something.
It's so obnoxious.
I know, but it'd be so cool if you take it out for a drive. Like, the amount of people that are looking go like, oh, it's a Fast and Furious car.
They got an invite though.
Oh yeah.
Good.
Flips.
Which one up there?
There's one up there. I'm waiting for it to close the door.